This month, we've added our 22nd member this year, so we're doing really well. I'm also the past admissions chair. If you'd like to join our happy band, we have applications in the back. We're really happy to have Rosa here tonight. Rosa's been a lamb marked 5 years?
No, much more.
Much more? 10 years. And it's always wonderful when we have a recital by Rosa. Peter's going to do the introductions.
Thank you.
And hope you will join us afterwards. We're going to have a reception on floor 2M, which is our pub and restaurant. And they are more than happy to take your credit cards down there. If you come down here, there's some seats on this side of the room. And Peter has something to deliver.
Hello, everybody. Yes, I'm Peter DeZosa, one of the members here. And yeah, very excited about Rosa with Argentinian heritage in our own family. We have a letter from the person who is an anchor reporter at Channel 41. For those of you who have UHF, does anybody remember that? So there was VHF. That channel that used to be available when you tuned in is Channel 41. And the tradition continues. I'm so glad to see there's still numbers, but now they go up to the 2000s. If you turn on your television, you'll still find this channel, which gives you some sampling of a lot of Spanish culture and some cinema. From Univision, "Dear and admired Rosa, it goes without saying that the select group of spectators that accompanies you tonight is privileged by the fact of attending the recital of a virtuoso who, through her piano and enormous talent, will take them through masterful pieces by great masters such as Villa-Lobos, Piazzolla, Ginastera, and other jewels of the Latin American and Spanish classical repertoire. As an immigrant to this great American nation, I am deeply grateful to you, Rosa, for spreading around the world the majestic musical creations on the piano, and through them building, repairing, and strengthening cultural bridges between nations, neither more nor less than honoring bridges as you baptized your most recent album. So look for that album, it's called Bridges. As an immigrant journalist, I feel doubly grateful. Your presence and projection is forceful testimony of the immeasurable musical contribution that enriches the artistic legacy of immigrants in the capital of the world. My pride is still major, knowing that your concert tonight will contribute to the noble cause promoted by the Lambs Club and Lambs Foundation, mentioning that there is a special portion, you know, the club itself has a philanthropic side. So anything that is, say, donated tonight will go to the Lambs Foundation in furtherance of the artistic purpose and of the donations that are made therefrom. From the distant shores of Espirito Santo in Brazil, receive all my admiration and affection, Victor Javier Solano, the anchor reporter for Channel 41. So, thank you for that. Yeah, it gives us a sense of some, well, the world is a lot of the European influence, certainly Latin America. So we welcome to the stage, I think, if she is ready, or maybe I'm going to get her. Rosa, are you nearby? See, I am beginning to think I have one more function to perform, so I will be right back.
Peter!
Wow, it's on the other side of the club. This is the rest, ladies and gentlemen, Rosa Antonelli.
Hi, Robert. Members, my friends, and also tonight we have the honor of the company from representatives from the Argentinian consulate in New York. We have the Deputy Consul General Guillermo Olivares and his wife, the cultural attaché Noelia Dutré, and the Deputy Consul General Nelson Martin. And tonight I'm going to present to you a very, very special concert called The Romantic Spirit of Latin America. And I'd like to explain to you why I chose this title. We know that through the history in the 18th and 19th century, we had a large migration from people from Europe to Latin America. They have this romantic idea of a new home, a new life, a new beginning. But also, they left their loved ones and they left their land. This created an special feeling for the composers who grew up with these families. They have all this particular expression about love, about hope, about melancholy. And I also found out, and I keep searching all the time, that most of the composers from Latin America, for some reason, and I think this is the reason, they, all the pieces are related to some kind of love. No, dedicated, we have a romantic love, falling in love, being in love, and losing that love in some ways. But also we have the love for a country, the love for a family, the love for friends. And all the pieces we are going to listen today, they have a story that the composer wrote about it, and the music expresses very clear. You know, I am dedicating for the last 12 years to promote these wonderful composers. I made my name with the traditional composers from Europe, but then when I found the beauty of these composers, I just felt to make them know more. And I'm going to start with a piece by an Argentinian composer who was my composition teacher at the National Conservatory. His name is Ángel La Sala. And he wrote this piece when I was his student. And he said, Rosa, one day I want you to play this piece for the world. The name of the piece is Romancero. It means a person who is in a stage of love the whole time. That's why I chose this piece to be the opening of this concert. And I did the world premiere of this piece in my first CD with these composers in 2009, actually called Esperanza Sounds of Hope. Then I'm going to start with Romancero by Ángel La Sala. Thank you. Argentina. I'm going to perform several pieces by Piazzolla. And now, talking about the love for a family, I'm going to perform a tango by Piazzolla, Adios Nonino. This tango, together with another one I'm going to perform later on, they were chosen as the best pieces in Latin America, the best ten compositions in the history. And he wrote this tango, he was in a tour in Puerto Rico, and he found out that he died in an accident, actually on a bike. He fell and he died. He came back to Mar del Plata, where he was from, and he wrote a few weeks later this tango. He wrote an original Nonino when he was alive, and he wrote this tango, Adios Nonino, goodbye dad. He called the father Nonino as a nickname, in Italian actually his grandfather. For you this tango.
Thank you.
Also that all these composers, they of course had the academic training in their countries, but also all of them went later on to Europe to do another academic training, and this is why they have this beautiful variety of styles and harmonies and beauty. Then Balsador by Heitor Villa-Lobos.
Thank you.
Kevin Fitzpatrick and Peter De Sosa.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Now, coming back to Argentina, I'm going to perform a piece called Ballad for a Wild Impetuous Man. Piazzolla wrote the first version in 1960, and then later on he wrote about this man who was on the street in Buenos Aires. This was the other piece was chosen as the best Latin American pieces in the history, together with Adios Manino. And then this man who was on the street and fell in love with a woman, and he went and he bought flowers, and the woman was there waiting. Then he invited her to accompany him in his impetuous love. Then finally she does it, and then at the end of the piece, they are both screaming on the street how beautiful love they have.
Thank you.
Now I'm going to perform a piece from Cuba, Ernesto Lecuona. It's a beautiful piece that all of you know, and I fell in love with this piece before, but more like a few months ago, and I decided to make my own arrangements. It's always in my heart.
Wow. Coming back to Argentina, another tango by Piazzolla. He wrote this tango when he was in Paris studying with Nadia Boulanger, and he was so grateful because she encouraged him to write the classical tango.
he was a classical composer. He had symphonies, he had orchestra, concertos for orchestra. Actually, he did the first symphony in New York many years before. And then he wrote chamber music, and then between Gina Stera and Nadia Boulanger, they told him, Astor, this is what you like the theme of the tango, but you have all the harmonies from the classical music. And she encouraged him. Then when he decided to come back to Buenos Aires, he had this mix of emotions because he loved to be in Paris, but he loved to come back to Buenos Aires. And he wrote this a particular tango, and he was writing it when, or inspiring when he was assigned to the Sena River, and also admiring all the palaces in France, Imperial by Piazzolla.
In Texas?
That's why the ambassador from Argentina couldn't come today. He wanted to attend here. And you know that Ponce, the Mexican composer, he was separated for political reasons from his wife for several years. He had to go to Cuba. And then his wife called Clema, all the pieces that he composed in that time, they were inspiring in the love for her and the sadness that they were separated for such a long time. Then I'm going to perform an intermezzo by Ponce. Intermezzo in music, it means something in between. You know? It's like a feeling, then coming back to some memories and the feelings again. It's a freestyle in between. Also this request from many people to perform this tango. It's called Liber Tango. It's the love for freedom, the freedom in the way that Piazzolla finally found his freedom from life in composing and getting the rights from his music. It was the first time that he had the rights from his music. He had the food, he had an apartment, and this is the first piece he wrote after the Italian company gave him this work. And then it's a special kind of freedom, it's like reaching a goal, no? Libertad.
Thank you.
unbelievable. And I admire Piazzolla so much because he was fighting all his life for his music. He was old when he wrote this, when he achieved this goal. It's a great spirit, no? To have around. Now, for the end of the concert, another request I have from the audience, I'm going to perform a piece by Ginastera. And I like this piece so much for the end, because it's a love story as Romeo and Juliet, but with a happy ending. It was based in, from the ballet Estancia, in French, that Ginastera wrote. The whole ballet is a love story. It's a love story between the daughter of the owner of the ranch and one of the workers. The father didn't accept originally at the beginning that love, but finally he accepted. And in the first piece, Dance of the Wheat, it describes where the workers are working, planting in the really early in the morning, the seeds, and you see all kinds of lights, and they were in love, they were looking at each other. And in the second part, the Malambo, the last piece, you know that in Argentina there is a contest for the Malambo, the dance. It's a very difficult dance, and they said that the worker won that competition. And that made the owner change his mind. From the Sweet Estancia back at the ranch by Ginastera. Thank you.
Round of applause for Rosa. Yeah. One more thing for you all to do before you fold up the chairs and bring them up, and it'll be the highlight of your Friday night. Is Monday? This Monday is somebody's birthday in this room.
Right.
I'm not gonna give it away. And I know Robert's going to take her to a very expensive restaurant, but we won't be there. So I thought, wouldn't it be nice if 65 of Rosa's friends, fans, and lambs could all sing Happy Birthday. Now, Happy Birthday wasn't written by a lamb. A lamb wrote Rhapsody in Blue, which is probably a better song anyway, right? On White Christmas. But I'll start. Okay, ready?
Happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday dear Rosa, happy birthday to you.
So join us on floor 2M for martinis and drinks right now, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was wonderful. Oh, so nice. We all have to charge a birthday card for your sign of the birthday.
How are you? Did you enjoy it?
Thank you.
Very much. Yes, she's always great.